grabbed 2 feet of Jarasandha and executed him. Jarasandha had the strength of 2,000 elephants, but Bhim, grabbed the feet of Jarasandha, turned him upside down, and bifurcated him from his anus, his belly, and nose, his forehead. Everything was cut into half, and he grabbed both pieces and then threw them crosswords. So how powerful is Bhima that he can defeat Jarasandha? But Samudrasan is worshipping Gauranga. Samudrasan is worshipping Radha Krishna, and Samudrasan has a mood of human-like sweetness. So by that mood of human-like sweetness, so what to speak of? Even Krishna is defeated in front of the Madhurya devotees who are worshipping Radha Rani. Then what to speak of Bhimsen, who is a devotee of Dwarkadish and who is endowed with some 50% mood of Pandavas? So, Samudrasen received the darshan of Sri Krishna along with the gopis and Bhimsen did not receive the darshan of Radha Krishna in Kumudvan. So, this is the land of Gauranga. So what to speak of anyone else? Radha Rani, she can bind Krishna and completely control him, subjugate him by his love. So this is the power of Srimati Radha Rani. So those who worship lotus feet of Gaur Sundar, they will quickly obtain holy power and they can even control Krishna. So how much power is in among the devotees who take shelter of Radha Rani, they become very strong and they can even subjugate Krishna. So although that person may be very low class, but because he has taken shelter at the lotus feet of Srimati Radhika, he becomes so powerful that he can even subjugate Krishna. So this is the power of the shelter of the lotus feet of Radhika. Well, if one takes shelter at the lotus feet of Radhika, takes shelter of the Navadvip Dham, and takes shelter of Gauranga Sundar, whose lotus feet are not different from the lotus feet of Radhika, even that person is insignificant. He'll become powerful enough to control Krishna. Shyamkund, and they have become trees, and they have become trees, and they are doing bhajan. So Raghunathas Goswami was ordered by Krishna in the dream to renovate Radha Kunda and Shyamkund. Radha Kunda was completely renovated and it was made into a square. But when Shyamkunda was being renovated, that time he had a dream and the 5 trees came in his dream and told that we are 5 Pandavas. We are Yudhishthir, Nakul, Sahadeva, Bhim and Arjun. We are doing bhajan on the bank of Shyamkunda and you should please don't cut us, because if you cut us, then we will not go to the bhajan. Then Raghunathas Goswami, why did I have to pray to Raghunathas Goswami? Because Raghunathas Goswami is a Rati Manjari. She is the gatekeeper of the Kunja of Radha Krishna. She is most dear to Radha Rani and she is completely Tadatmya Vikradhika. So therefore, even 5 Pandavas had to bow down to the lotus feet of Raghunathas Goswami, Rati Manjari or Tulsi Manjari. So more superior than Aishwarya is Madhurya. Worship of Krishna in the human-like sweetness, in the mood of Manjari Bhav, is million times superior than Aishwarya Bhav of Bhima and Pandavas. So there is an intense eagerness to meet Krishna in the Madhurya Rasa, and wonderful nature and variegated pastimes of loving sports of Radha Krishna continuously manifest like an unbroken stream in the heart of the sadhaka when he takes shelter at the lotus feet of Radhika in total Madhurya. So many different Vaishnavas will describe the pastimes that took place today. So we request Pujaniya Srimati Umadevi to speak about today's topic. There is a cordless mic. So one cordless mic should be given. So she can stay there, yeah.
Mic.
Shivan Prabhu, wherever you are, please come to the stage.
Pujya Pat Janardhan Maharaj, Govinda Maharaj, Harijan Maharaj, Purandar Prabhu, aap log stage mein aane ka kashta karein.